everything goes from internal motivation. As I said, keeping power, that's a strategy, if we may say strategy. To keep this, just he needs external enemy. Because all authoritarian regimes usually doing this way, because you cannot find just people responsible inside Russia. When you suppress opposition, just people wouldn't believe that it's because of opposition, because just opposition have no influence on any of those processes. That's why external enemies necessary. And Mr. Putin managed to find it. It's not, it was not so difficult. The United States and Canada in particular. And that's what the enemy was and is. And therefore, it's important to demonstrate some kind of fight.
It's Ukraine.
Georgia, for instance, that was the first taste of war. When that was explained, that is United States provocation and just pressure on Russia, etc., etc. And Putin wanted to have a quick victory to demonstrate to people his strong position. And he managed to do this. And the West simply swallowed and digested that. 3 months after, business as usual. No single point of the agreement was signed, so-called Sarkozy plan, that Sarkozy was chairman of the Council in Europe. And nothing was implemented, but everyone forgot about that. Pragmatic interests or real politics, that was just devoted to attention. What was the reason for all these things in Crimea and in Donbass? Problem of language, not more than that. In Russia, in Ukraine, just there was no single complaint ever for these 23 years of existence of independent Ukraine. Recent president Yanukovych, just Russian speaking person, he couldn't even study just Ukrainian. And there was no single just violation of any rights of Russian speaking people. That is imitation or just even not professional artificial creation of reasons. Of course, in this time, I, with great satisfaction, just can say that West suddenly just started to understand that it's not we shouldn't be foolish by such a Putin behavior and taking a principled position. Value-based position. And I'm very glad that there is transatlantic unity. Mr. Putin didn't expect that, of course. That is the most important point. And he very much was shocked of the position of Germany. He spent so much efforts of, say, buying German industry and so that the